keep your hands to yourself.
Come on, we gotta get going. Judy calls.
Well, had all you can handle for one night, huh?
I never have enough of you, darling. You know that. Hey! Think this place got a breakfast deal?
This place? Sure. Just bang on the wall. I'm sure you get something.
Yeah, no, no, don't knock it. It's got cable TV and the price is right.
Uh-huh, and it's 30 miles from base.
Come on. You know it wouldn't do either of us any good if they knew I was poking my right-hand man.
Oh, is that what you're doing?
What I mean is we function professionally first. Look, it violates PRP.
You think nobody knows about us?
Yeah, well, whatever. Look, it's just best we keep an official distance, that's all.
Mm-hmm. The problem is your official distance starts the minute we get out of bed. I don't need that.
Oh, now, come on the road, darling. You know you're the only irresistible thing in my life.
Cut me some slack, will you?
Come on, darling.
I'm calling a cab.
Now, that's dumb.
Why? You wouldn't want them to see you dropping me off, would you? It might violate PRP.
Ezrim Control, descend. 35,000. Contact Istanbul Control.
0 at 25.
Alitalia 101, Ezrim Control. New heading, turn left to 230 degrees.
Then I'll tell you 101. Understand. Turning left to heading 230.
Chief Supervisor, please.
350, final.
I have an unidentified aircraft, no mode C identification.
ID yet on the missile?
Not at this time, sir. We're just beginning to get a line plot.
We have a preliminary missile trajectory moving north northeast from Turkey to the Soviet border, sir.
Check our bases, Europe satellite launches, and call NASA.
Yes, sir.
I'm moving our alert status to Snowman.
Congratulations!
How's the wedding?
It was great.
Oh, you got the wedding.
Yeah. I remember planning this thing for 6
6 months easy. We get everybody in from out of town, and what happens? I pull a week on alert duty starting on our honeymoon.
You do that to you on purpose, Captain. You should have kept quiet about the wedding.
That's right. Yeah. You know, you kept your mouth shut. You'd be sitting in Waikiki right now in a hotel room.
Oh, no, wait a second. If we were in a hotel room right now, I don't think we'd be sitting.
All our missiles are accounted for, sir. The Europeans report no launches.
This makes no sense. I want a systems malfunction check.
I have checks, sir. The target could be anywhere in that triangle, sir.
Every damn target's in the Soviet Union.
Oh, my God!
Sir, we have a nuclear detonation in the Soviet Union.
I want absolute verification.
Come on, move! Let's go!
Sir, a Soviet nuclear response is in progress. We have positive verification.
Get me General Redding on the double.
Yes, sir.
And change the alert code to cocked pistol.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Lori, how's it going?
Hey. Missed you last night.
So, how was Hopalong Cassidy?
Oh, God. Starting to drive me crazy, you know? I mean, so in love with himself. Sometimes feel like I'm intruding.
Well, he's a pilot. What else is new?
That's bogus. You know, we're all pilots.
Yeah, but we're not guys.
Yes, sir, we've got them on the line.
All targets appear to be within the continental United States, Alaska, and Hawaii.
I'm putting us in combat footing. We're going from preliminary attack conference to attack conference, and I want the PSYOP computer options on this now.
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Mr. President, I have General Redding for you.
Fine. Put him through.
Sir, we are facing an extremely serious situation. I have asked for full attack conference. My authority, we're moving from cock pistol to roundhouse. Is your EWO there, sir?
Where's the Secretary of Defense? Why isn't he making this call?
We've been unable to reach him. You'll need your emergency war order officer, sir. We need the codes, Mr. President.
Just gonna say that's that.
Thank you, sir.
Come on, hurry up.
Hey, Donnie. All right, Major. What's going on with you and Captain Moreau?
I don't know. She's okay. She's great, as a matter of fact. She is an Air Force brat.
I don't know. I got a lot of respect for her. I think she's a damn good pilot.
Yeah, well, just do yourself a favor and never sleep with an officer.
Mr. President, an unidentified missile, origin Turkey, detonated over Soviet Donetsk at 0530 Zulu. It was not fired by U.S. forces. The Soviets have chosen to launch a strike against us.
There has to be a mistake. Turkey's NATO. We certainly wouldn't fire a missile at the Soviet Union. Now, who the hell did?
We don't know, sir. It could have been stolen. It could have been a trick.
What the hell do you say? Our relations couldn't possibly be better.
Sir, I know it's hard to believe. Nevertheless, we are in the secondary stages of a Soviet counterforce strike. Our computers show random attack by Russian submarines, swarm attack by land-based ICBMs. We need your authority, sir. We need the codes, Mr. President. We are under attack. This is Pearl Harbor.
Come here now, would you?
Hey, O'Toole, are you in here again?
How's the honeymoon, man?
A little short, but sweet.
She's good for you, she was for me.
Frick.
God. Get
your head, man. Oh. The Soviet president, the secretary of state, and my national security advisor here as soon as possible.
There's no time for that, sir.
General, I will not make a decision of this magnitude without...
You don't have to. PSYOP has anticipated this. We need your authority for the codes, Mr. President.
No, General. This is my responsibility. I will not act precipitously on the basis of some goddamn computer.
The goddamn computer will be destroyed in 21 minutes, sir. Along with everyone here.
Mr. President, message coming in on direct teletype from the Soviet president.
We'll take that. Did you hear that, General?
Yes, sir, I did. I also show a submarine-launched missile directed vicinity Washington, D.C., arriving in less than 7 minutes, sir.
General, I'm going to read that message.
Sir, impact in less than 6 minutes. You're wasting time, sir. Your own.
I'll call you back, General. Sedgwick.
Give me Alice in the looking glass, please.
Yes, sir.
Time for you to go, Admiral.
Sir, are we absolutely certain about this?
We have to have at least two command planes in the air at the same time.
The Navy doesn't like to abandon ship, General.
This is my ship. Yours is the E-4. Admiral, are you waiting for me to order you to go?
No, sir. Goodbye, sir.
General, I have Alice on the looking glass plane.
Alice, harpoon is launched.
The alert truck will be waiting outside, sir.
Good luck, son.
Shove it up their commie asses, sir.
Alice.
Yes, sir.
You have your battle plans, their missile impact projections?
Clear as a bell, sir.
Print them out. You won't have computers much longer.
We've taken care of it, sir.
I'll try to check back in with you again, Charlie. My clock says SAC goes in 19 minutes.
We'll be here, General.
Mr. President, by now you will know a nuclear device was detonated over the Soviet city of Donetsk. At that time, it appeared the missile was launched by NATO forces from Turkey, and our defensive system retaliated automatically. We now realize the first missile was launched by dissident members of our own military who feared our vastly improved relations and who conspired to overthrow this government and force war between our two countries.
Our missiles are targeted for your long-range bomber bases, an ICBM complex in Montana, the NORAD facility at Cheyenne Mountain, and the SAC command at Omaha. A single warhead is directed at Andrews Air Force Base. The target is symbolic, as this is the base from which you would leave Washington. To be blunt, Mr. President, you now have three choices. Accept the damage, and we will stop. Your second choice is to respond with a limited counterattack that inflicts on my nation a similar amount of damage. We will each lose between 6 and 9 million people in such an attack. This is acceptable to us.
Get your hands off me!
There's a puzzle in here, gang. Come on, let's go!
I realize this is a tremendous price to pay. And I know all too well the enormous military and political pressure you will be under to take your third option, to respond massively.
Scramble start, battery on.
If this is your ultimate decision, I will have no choice but to reply with total nuclear commitment.
Get your towel, Lieutenant.
These fucking drills.
I urge you to look at the tremendous gains we have made in the last few years. Let us not allow human error and the technology of the Cold War to destroy our hopes and our world.
Start all engines.
Start all engines. Good start, all engines. Generators, all engines.
We're now on internal power. Clear checks. Come on, come on, let's go.
Come on, O'Toole, let's go, let's go!
Major O'Toole's soaking wet, sir.
Just for goddamn sure.
Well, I will send Moreau to dry him off as soon as the drill's over.
I know you think it's real every time the siren goes off, but let's just get this over and get O'Toole out of here.
Yeah, you better think it's real, Angel. It's simpler that way.
Sky King, this is Cable Car. Stand by to copy your red dot 5 message. Message is, Alpha, Golf, Hotel, India, Delta. Authentication time is 200605 Zulu. Authentication is Sierra, Foxtrot. I say again, Sky King. Sky King, this is Cable Car.
All right, gang, what's the drill? Do I shut him down or what?
Message is Alpha, Golf, Hotel, India, Delta.
Pilot EW. This is a valid, I repeat, valid launch message.
Authentication is Sierra, Foxtrot.
Radar, co-pilot, verify.
Pilot radar, that's valid.
Roger, confirm, it's a valid launch message.
Prepare for scramble takeoff. Co-pilot ready. Co-pilot ready. Navigator ready.
Ready.
Sir, you have less than 2 minutes before Andrews is hit. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, I do.
General, I want a response designed as closely as possible to the Soviet attack. And under no circumstances are their losses to exceed ours. Do you understand?
Sir, we believe the Soviet president is out of position and their military are running things now. You are being conned on a level unprecedented in human history.
General, I will hear no more of this. Now you instruct the computer. At the appropriate time, I will activate the codes through the proper civilian authorities as the law stipulates.
Trinity.
Strike assigned targets if not recalled prior to positive control point.
Where do you think they hit us?
I don't know. Something like northwest of here. Not at Andrews.
What kind of damage are we talking about?
This time of night, I'd say 50,000 people just died.
Situation room? Omaha's back, sir.
The White House, sir.
Sir, General, I'm putting you on a speaker.
They overshot Andrews by 13 miles, sir.
The blast wave rolled up Rock Creek Park and took out Walter Reed Hospital. My father was there.
I'm truly sorry, General.
A father should die before his son. Anyway, the hospital wasn't a target. You were. You're lucky, Mr. President. You get what I want, a second chance.
I don't follow you, General.
Sir, this is just for openers. They'll go for our bases with their missiles and destroy our offensive capability. Then they'll mop up our cities with their bombers. You get a second chance to save the world from those bastards.
Try your curtain, Moreau.
Negative. I'm not pulling my curtain.
Close your damn curtain or I'll close
Negative.
It for you.
Negative. There's too much commercial traffic out here, Cassidy. I'm not pulling my curtain.
Hell. Yourself together.
Major?
Shockwave.
Oh, shit.
Shockwave. Briggs.
Major, O'Toole's dead.
What?
Shockwave threw him into the instrument panel. He didn't have his harness on.
I think he broke his neck.
Shit. Radar. Gunner, what's our status?
I've got one detonation at 6 o'clock, 10 miles.
And I've got one 15 miles dead ahead.
Fairchild is gone, sir. The base is totally destroyed.
Negative. I don't show that. Nothing happened to the base. It's still there.
What the hell's going on with Tyler? You can see Fairchild's gone.
Tyler doesn't have much to go home to now.
General, don't you consider it possible that the Soviet president was sincere?
I believe he is.
Mr. President, as God is my witness, it makes no difference. The Chinese, in accordance with our treaty, have hit the Russians on their border.
We can't even tell whether the Soviet president is still in control.
All communications to the Soviet Union are down, sir.
What does PSYOP suggest?
A two-part sequence. Launch half our ICBMs targeted Russian silos. Their computer would be hard-pressed to tell which of our silos are empty and which are hid.
How will the Soviets respond in this scenario?
We cannot read what we must assume is extreme political confusion in Moscow at this moment.
What would our computers say?
In a politically normal situation, our computer would predict they would launch their ICBMs massively.
At what targets?
All our bases, military targets.
And cities?
Some, more than likely.
Excuse me, sir.
Mr. President, the Soviets have initiated a second launch.
Launch? At us?
We can't tell. Are you suggesting we wait? This facility, SAC, goes in 3 minutes. If we don't hit them hard and hit them now, we may never get a second chance.
Sir.
I repeat, there is a second Soviet launch.
Mr. President, we have to get you out of here. Please, sir.
I'll go with the computer. We will launch according to procedure. Tom. Do you think the president was sincere?
Mr. President, please don't torture yourself. Please. We have to leave
Tell
immediately.
Me, do you think he was sincere, Tom?
Please, sir.
General, I have the authenticator card. Dayward, Cottonmouth. Command word, Trinity. Action word, Jericho.
You got it?
Yeah, I got him.
Okay. I got him.
Nav co-pilot, are we still on course for our positive control point?
I'm not really sure where we are, Captain.
Tyler. Check your INS coordinates and your heading right there, man.
Hey, you do your job, Rand, and I'll do mine, all right?
All right, everybody, listen up. We're all under EWO, emergency war orders. Is that understood? We got a mission to complete. We are EWO. Am I reaching you, hamheads? We will proceed to our positive control point and hold for orders. Let's get these curtains open.
Hey, Major, how about turning on the heater?
Well, Tyler, glad you could join us. Hey, Hooks, you think you can handle O'Toole's toys for us?
I think I can handle it.
Well, congratulations. You just received the first battlefield commission of this war, whatever the hell this thing is.
I'll take the job, Major. You can keep the bars.
Mr. President, two shots have been fired now. We're gonna run to the chopper.
Where are the shots coming from?
Just people, sir.
You got the last train out of town, sir.
Move now, sir. Follow me.
Harpoon, I don't know if the president will reach Andrews. All our military bases are being hit. Who's available to succeed?
General, the vice president and most of the cabinet live in Northwest Washington. We've been unable to contact them. The only one that we're sure of is the secretary of the interior. He was inspecting a wilderness preserve near Baton Rouge.
Is the FBI out looking for him?
And the army. E-4's 2 hours from touchdown in Baton Rouge.
Alice, you're reading our new target projections in the Soviet Union.
I got everything I need, sir.
And our current impact areas in the U.S.?
Yes, sir.
Well, I've done about all I can. You and Harpoon take it from here. Well, buddy.
Yeah, Clay.
Happy hunting.
Sir, we can't make it to Andrews. It's not safe.
I thought they missed Andrews.
That's correct, sir, but we can't get a plane in. We're going to try for Dover. Mr. President, the second Soviet launch, we were mistaken. It was directed against the Chinese, not at us.
So by launching at the Soviets, we've kicked things up a level.
It looks that way. Soviets have started to kick us back now, so it looks like we've entered another level of escalation.
Tom, I've got to turn this thing off. Can you reach a command plane?
We can try, sir.
Tyler's picked up a civilian radio station.
Tyler, turn that damn thing off.
All right. You hear that music, Major? That's life down there, sir. This whole thing simulated. It's a drill. I mean, it's pretty convincing, but I knew you guys were joking me.
Tyler, damn you.
Major, quit worrying. It's a drill. Who gives a shit?
Tyler, they're dead. Everybody, you got that? They're dead. You're still alive. You got a job to do, so turn off the fucking radio and do it.
Way to warm him up, Cassidy.
I don't need that from you.
Only the very low frequency seems to be working consistently. Well, the other systems on board, two or three work off and on, the rest are still down.
What's with Harpoon? You pick up the Secretary of Interior yet?
I touched down 5 minutes ago, but it was a damn risky landing. I don't know if I would have taken the chance, General.
We had to, Sam. The President's chopper's confirmed down.
What about voice contact?
We need a civilian leader, and he's next in line of succession.
Sarah, we don't know who else is still alive. We're not even sure Harpoon is after the right guy.
What I was sure of was with the B-52s.
Well, last we knew, 15 of them were still flying, sir. Only half of them airborne, refueled. Smoking again, sir.
Secretary of Interior.
Secretary, this morning yet?
Maybe, yes, sir.
President?
Barely.
Injured, sir? You need assistance?
No. Just get the Secret Service aboard so we can get our ass out of here before the old state of Louisiana rushes in.
Please follow me, sir.
President, Harpoon. I'm sorry that the band won't be playing Hail to the Chief, sir. Follow me.
How bad is it?
Well, under the circumstances, it can't be very good, can it, sir?
Are we losing the war?
Well, I'm not sure that that's the issue, Mr. President. You need to be briefed.
Tell you what, Radner. I just want to get my MBA, man, and I'm out of here. Back to a nice, quiet, sane life. I can't handle these war games anymore.
Okay, mission briefing. You're Kutz. Targets.
Targets?
Come on, Tyler.
You with us, guy?
Satellite tracking station, heavy industry, electronic.
Civilian population? Tyler, Russians, how many?
Just under a million, sir.
All right, Tyler's good. Just hang in there, buddy. Your Kutz gets 1 megaton ground burst, low level, departing initial point, inbound to target.
Roger, inbound to target, heading 230, altitude 500 feet above ground level.
Sure.
Release airspeed 385 knots.
Sure.
Bomb release 20 seconds from my hack. Ready? Ready, hack. 20 seconds to bomb release. Escape heading straight through 230 degrees.
Okay. Straight down Karl Marx Street.
10 seconds.
And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And bomb away.
Pushing over. Leveling at 500 feet. Tail to the blast.
Bye-bye, Air Kutsk. Bye-bye, little Pomishkas. Drill complete. Good practice run, guys. We're on time.
Sir, we're now 75 miles from our positive control point.
You think it's gonna be that easy on a real city?
Yeah. No problem. Bro, I'm gonna tell you something. You're a damn good pilot. One of the best I've had in that right seat. I never thought you'd fuck up mentally or physically, but you are fucking up right now.
So far, it appears that the Soviet attacks have been limited to our military installations. And wherever they border population centers, I assume that we have suffered considerable casualties.
Have they hit our cities yet?
No, sir. Communications are down, reports are hard to get, but apparently it has been a rather even exchange.
Even so far.
Now, Mr. President, we have to make a decision. Very soon, our bombers will be here. They're positive control points. If they are sent in, they will reach their target areas in 4 to 6 hours.
Why haven't they been sent in already?
Sir, if we don't turn this thing off, in a few hours, Soviet bombers will be roaming through this country, taking out our cities.
Admiral, excuse me, sir, if I may. Mr. President, I'm Colonel Fargo.
What do you do around here?
Soviet capabilities expert, sir.
I see.
It may be that the Admiral is overestimating the enemy. Most Soviet bombers are so old, they still have propellers. The Minnesota Air National Guard could probably knock them down.
Well, do you want to get on the telephone and order them into the air, Colonel? Because every transistor in Minnesota is burned out. Now, Mr. President, we won't be able to stop half of those Soviet bombers. They will destroy our cities at will.
And we'll send our bombers over there and do the same thing to them.
Most of ours were caught on the ground, sir.
Are you telling me that they hit more of our installations than we hit theirs?
Sir, you have to realize this is not the kind of war where you can add up the score to see who wins.
Believe me, mister, winning is everything.
I agree, Mr. President. Up to now, you haven't gotten the whole picture.
In a minute, Colonel. What about our subs? How many warheads we got down there?
Almost 6,000, sir.
6,000 nuclear warheads.
Yes, sir.
Well, shouldn't we launch them before their bombers hit our cities?
Our submarines are automatically issued sailing orders instructing them to run with their radios off so that they cannot be tracked. Now, in about 7 hours, they will surface and listen for new orders. If they hear nothing, they'll fire.
Why wait 7 hours?
A missile hits its target in 30 minutes, but the bombers require nearly 8 hours to hit theirs. So that the bombers are slow, natural pauses, giving you and the Soviet president time to turn off this war. Now, sir, you have a copy of his message in your folder, sir. He offers to accept an equal amount of damage to the Soviet Union.
Oh, yes, I see. And we're supposed to just take his word for it, huh?
Mr. President, historical fact. The Soviets have always been willing to accept massive losses to achieve victory.
Colonel, this isn't the 1950s. They're not looking for new worlds to conquer anymore. Mr. President, I have a very hard time believing that the Soviets want this war any more than we do. Recall some of our bombers and see how the Soviets respond.
Well, I...
Mr. President, there is another solution. Cut the head off the chicken.
Hey, Brad. Bradner. I'll say it happened, okay? I will say it happened, but you gotta meet me halfway on this, okay? What do you say, buddy? Just meet me halfway on this.
Shut up.
Just meet me halfway, Radner. It happened, okay? But not to Timmy, okay? It happened to Annie, but it didn't happen to Timmy, okay? Because I never said goodbye to him, Radner.
Hey, Tyler. How you doing down there, buddy?
Oh, shit.
Hang on here. We got bogeys. 12 o'clock.
Bogeys my ass. Them's bandits.
Distance, velocity?
30 miles or faster. Closing very fast. We have two. Correction, we got three bandits.
Equipment and systems check. Jamming decoys. Chap, we better look like an armada.
Chap, it hit blast release, sir. 25 miles. 20 miles.
Must be Fox Bats. Specs.
Top speed on a MiG-25, Mach 2.8. Range 1,500 miles one way.
15 miles.
Armaments?
Two heat-seeking missiles, range 10 miles. Two radar-guided missiles, range 15 miles. They'll use both. No cannon armaments.
10 miles. Missiles launched. We have two missiles launched.
Our decoys are jammed. Shovel that stuff like hay hooks.
You got it, Major.
Shit.
They're going for the decoys.
Hooray! Yeah! Two missiles down, Major.
Hey, hang on to your shorts, Ace. Breaking right, coming around to our rear.
Still got more missiles out there.
I know. Are you with me?
You bet.
Taking her down low.
The most powerful enemy can be defeated only by the utmost effort and by seizing every opportunity. Lenin said that, sir. The Soviets live by it. And I believe if we call back our bombers, the Soviets would simply see this as a sign of weakness.
That's a dangerous speculation, Colonel.
Now, let him finish, please.
Sir. May I go to the map, sir?
Yes, of course.
Sir, these red dots represent Soviet leadership bunkers. Inside, you'll find the party hierarchy, the presidium, KGB, the president himself. They are the head of the communist body. You cut off that head and the body dies. Sir, they've got a massive arsenal over there.
and we don't know whose finger's on that button. We can order our B-52s on a grand tour of the Soviet Union.
This is madness, sir.
Yeah, we got madness piled on madness tonight.
Colonel Tallis, what would you do about the Soviet bombers?
Recalling our bombers won't stop them, sir. Sir, we have some fighters left. We have thousands of commercial jets. We can ram their bombers.
You're joking.
Is that possible?
Sir, there is no defense against this stuff. They have over 300 bombers, and what about their ICBMs?
You take out these red dots, there won't be anyone left to fire the ICBMs.
Sir, we are wasting time here. Use the pause. Settle things down.
The best defense, cut off the head of the Soviet chicken.
Harry Truman said he felt like a bale of hay landed on him. I feel like I got the whole damn barn. I need a moment alone.
Coming up to the next turn point. New heading will be 225. There's mountainous terrain after the turn point.
Roger that.
Come on. Come on, you bastard.
Down here.
I gotta get the president to a military hospital with a radio.
Radar, pilot. I'm Bomb One. Manual release on my hack. You have nuclear consent.
Roger. Armed mini release sequence standing by your hack.
5.5 miles in closing.
We'll be over the ridge in 40 seconds.
Let's close them. Still no bandits?
nothing came through that, Major.
Cassidy, what are you doing?
I'm about to take a look.
Negative. I don't want to see it.
Take the plane, Captain.
I've got it, pilot.
Sorry, but you have to hold
the President of the United States.
Look, ma'am, I don't have time for this right now.
Got a come on, boy, show him, show him.
Officer, let's get this man inside. Come on, let's go, let's go.
President?
Harpoon, do you think I'm scared?
You were a few minutes ago, sir. I hope you are now.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm scared. I'm scared of losing. We're going with the Grand Tour.
Sir.
History can't wait.
I hope there will be a history to hear you.
Where are you going?
To my quarters, sir.
Admiral? Sir, aren't you forgetting something? The card.
You'll need this. Orders to the bombers go through the looking glass plane. And the code at the top proves that you're authentic. The colonel will give you the word code.
Did you really forget to give me this?
I'm not really sure, sir. Good luck.
Thank you. I think I'm gonna need it.
Yes, we'll all need it tonight.
The president's legs are crushed. This man has a compound fracture of the arm and head injuries. Could we get more ice, please?
Just relax, Mr. President. You'll feel better in a minute. What's with the IV?
Lactated ringers, 2 milligrams of morphine.
Gotta get some security around.
Give him 2 more milligrams.
No morphine.
Whoa. Take it easy. You'll be okay, soldier.
Alice here.
Condor speaking.
E4. Day word.
Cottonmouth.
Command word.
Trinity.
Action word.
Jericho.
You have your card, sir?
I do.
Upper right-hand corner, please read the last 3 digits.
7C2.
C for what, sir?
Charlie.
Second line from the top, please read the middle sentence.
6D62.
D for what, sir?
Damn it! Are all you people waiting on World War IV, Alice?
You wish to issue an order change, sir?
I sure as hell do.
Did Harpoon give you the signal code, sir?
He's temporarily incapacitated.
Yes, sir. 44th Strategic coming. Can I give you some advice, sir?
Getting plenty of that down here.
I'm sure you have, sir. The situation is fluid. We've gotten our first coded messages from the ground. Garbled, but coded. That means we're getting our communications back.
Good, that's good news. Now, I'm ordering 2-1 Zebra.
We're getting things back, sir. I'd orbit and wait.
Well, then you orbit and wait. I have no time. The Russians have too many missiles, and the colonel says they're out of control.
Fargo? With all due respect, sir, I'd run this past Harpoon first.
Alice, implement 2-1 Zebra.
Yes, sir. It'll take a few minutes, sir.
Are you stalling me, Alice?
No, sir. At the hand sort this. New assignments, priorities. We're saying too much, sir.
Alice, get your tail moving. Fast.
Got a 2-1 Zebra.
Jesus. You're kidding.
Wish the hell I was.
Captain.
So tell me what I already know.
Orbit, await orders.
Get the feeling we're going around in circles?
This is one circle I'm not sure we should complete.
You're not suggesting treason, are you, darling?
Why don't presidents have a personnel reliability program?
Jesus, don't get on that now.
Yeah, well, who the hell did this? I bet you no president ever went through our little reliability program. You think the Politburo's got psychological screening or whatever they call it?
None of them would have passed.
Yeah, it's hard to find perfect people. None of us passed tonight.
You are getting philosophical in your sunset years, darling.
Hours. Sunset hours.
Major, we've got another SATCOM message coming in.
Come the orders to go back to Spokane.
We need some light!
This is Pit Stop 2. Please identify. Please speak English. Get the boss on the double. This is a priority channel. You're required to identify yourself.
What do you got, Hooks?
Message is 2-1 Zebra.
The hell's 2-1 Zebra? Demet Moreau, what's going on?
The Grand Tour.
What?
Precision bombing of political military infrastructure. Target Soviet city of Sharapovitz. Primary relocation site of Soviet president. Chief of KGB. Minister of Defense. Commanding general of Soviet rocket forces.
Leadership bunkers.
They want us to take out their big bananas.
I think somebody's gone bananas.
Request confirmation.
You just get promoted?
Request confirmation.
Do it, Hooks.
Yes, sir.
The hell are you looking at?
You know what this means?
Yeah. It means we don't have to drop a million tons of TNT on a bunch of civilians. Isn't that better, for God's sake?
You mean more satisfying?
Damn right! Maybe it'll help get this thing over with faster.
Faster? You do not kill the enemy's leaders. You know that. They know that. Somebody's got to be there to turn it off.
Confirm 2-1 Zebra. NCA code is Hen House.
Look up Hen House.
No.
The hell you want me to do? Write my congressman? It won't make any difference.
I know.
Nothing's going to change. Somebody will do it.
Sharapovitz will go, along with the president and the generals.
I know.
And New York, Kuzma, every goddamn thing in between.
I know, but I'm not gonna do it. I can't.
You can't?
I won't.
You'd have turned a Minuteman key without thinking.
They gave me time to think.
Hooker, get the hell out of here.
Yes,
what am I supposed to do? Shoot you? Eject you? Put you down on the ice?
Turn it off. Turn the plane, Major. That's what I want you to do. Turn the plane.
Cyanide. You got it? You are relieved, Captain. Get the hell out of here. Damn it, Earl. Don't leave me now.
So what's next?
God damn it, how the hell should I know?
War, sir. Under no circumstances will I supply you such information.
I know your E-4 aircraft is flying. Will you, for the sake of both our nations, transmit the message to the E-4 informing your president that our president wishes to communicate directly with him?
Look, mister, I don't know who you are, and I will not supply strategic information to any damn Russian.
This is the Soviet president. With whom am I speaking?
Done good, champ. We're not going in. There's no purpose in it.
Yes, sir.
Was a cop, Major.
I know, Red. She was a damn good one.
She protected us, Major.
I know. You should be proud of her.
You protected her.
I am emergency war order ready, sir.
I know, Tyler. We all were. Been evil for a long time now.
Coward! Just turn the shit, you coward! You coward!
Sorry, Ray.
Yeah, I know. I'll take care of him.
Captain, this just came in.
It's a little bumpy, but it's holding.
Roger, we see that ERTF.
Excuse me, sir. One of our bombers turned, General.
Who turned?
Polar Bear 1. Turned southeasterly. The date's been confirmed.
We have to inform Condor, sir.
Yeah? Of course we do.
What was that all about?
Tyler and I had a little failure to communicate.
Hey, Ty, are you all right?
I have no injuries, Captain. I am EWO ready, and you are cowardice.
Connie.
Please, take it easy, sir.
Sir? It's me. It's me, Tom. Tom, where are we? FEMA bunker at Olney, sir. What's the matter with me? Your legs are broken, sir. I can't see, Tom. All right. Sir, did you look at the blast? Did you see the blast? Anyone have any idea what's going on out there?
Excuse me, sir. Our preliminary data show that it could have been much worse. Most of the targets were military, and a few cities were hit intentionally.
Who are you?
Bascom, sir. Director, Northeast Region, FEMA, retired Army.
There is one more thing, sir. About an hour ago, we received a rather peculiar message on the radio from the Soviet Union. The speaker claimed to be the Soviet president.
Excuse me, sir. I talked to him. I'm sure he was an imposter. He wanted us to patch him through to the E-4.
Apparently, an alternate E-4 made its way out of Omaha and picked up a presidential successor in Baton Rouge. Successor? Everybody thinks you're dead, sir, including the Soviet president. That call was authentic. Well, who's acting as president? Apparently, the fate of the country is now in the hands of Secretary of the Interior, sir. We've got Alice in one plane and the Mad Hatter in the other.
What makes you so sure you're not talking to the Soviet president?
He was too rude, sir. He was far too rude for a national leader.
Rude? You want to hear a national leader get rude? What'd he say to you?
Well, sir, I...
Oh, for God's sake. He said Bascom couldn't find his ass with both hands and a hunting dog.
From what you just said, I'd say you hung up on the Soviet president. Get him back for me, and quickly.
Yes, sir.
What is your state of readiness? Speak, asshole. You ready? Are you ready?
This is strange, sir.
What is?
Well, I'm seeing more bandits.
But they just turned. They're turning back, sir.
Precedence, sir.
Oh, the hell with precedence. There's no precedence for anything tonight.
We send up interceptors and bring them down, sir.
You shoot them down.
first we try to force them to land, sir. Condor, sir, there's something you should know. The Soviet ears are opening. We're getting bits of messages from inside Russia.
Why wasn't I told about this?
We can't make much of it, sir, but we can determine they are rattled, just as we are.
You think we're rattled?
Yes, sir.
I'll let you in on a little secret, Alice. What rattles me most are my own damn military geniuses.
In this one, sir, there are no military geniuses.
Really?
General.
Captain?
He needs to know this, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
Shortly after Polar Bear 1 turned, the Soviet bomber squadron following them also turned.
Any others?
No, sir, just the one squadron.
Well, sir, it could be that they're signaling their willingness to stabilize at current levels. Why don't you turn more bombers and see if they reciprocate?
Oh, you know how I read this one, Alice. We have one deserter, they have a whole squadron. First time we come out ahead tonight.
I read it differently, sir. Turn the bombers. See what happens.
You don't understand what's going on here, do you? We stop now, we lose. This president has a determination to wage a nuclear war until an acceptable outcome is achieved.
Acceptable to whom, sir?
Acceptable to me and the American people. Now, you put another bomber on the hen house, fast. Did you get that?
I hear you, sir.
And you put out general orders to bring down Polar Bear 1. Did you hear that?
Yes, sir.
You don't sound convinced, General.
I don't believe I am, sir.
Mr. President, sir, we have the capability. Give the orders from here.
Fine, fine. We can send the orders from here.
I suggest you do that, sir.
Am I hearing you correctly?
I believe you did.
General, you're fired.
They'll shoot you for this, General.
Sam, old friend, I should find such an angel of mercy.
Radner? Books?
They're gone. How's the fuel?
96,000 pounds.
Not gonna get very far on that.
Yep. Got any ideas?
Think we could make Bora Bora?
Maybe we ought to face reality.
If we're lucky, reality's a firing squad.
And if we're unlucky?
Planet of the Apes, darling. Remember 2-1 Zebra?
Do we do anything right?
We did what we had to do.
Do we do anything right?
Mr. President.
Sir?
You are aware that one of your bombers
was turned, and in response, I turned a squadron of mine.
No, I was not aware of that, Mr. President. But it certainly is reassuring news.
Unfortunately, Mr. President, the remainder of both our bomber fleets continues to advance. But this will be nothing compared to the devastation from your submarine-based missiles. I believe they operate on a pre-programmed attack schedule, yes?
That is correct, sir.
How much time before they launch?
I can assure you, Mr. President, I'd tell you if I knew, but I have no idea.
Mr. President, my situation at this moment is most difficult. You must be aware I will no longer be able to control my forces if you are unable to control yours.
Well aware. Can you give me 1 hour, Mr. President? I'll try to turn those bombers around.
I will do everything in my power. But if the others here believe for an instant that you are insincere, I won't be able to give you 2 minutes.
Yes. Yes, I understand that.
Destiny be with you, my friend.
And God with you, Mr. President.
Almost time for sunrise.
I don't know if I want to see it.
Be glad something's here we couldn't screw up. I'm glad it's here. I'm glad you're here.
Excuse me, sir.
What?
The president is on the phone.
Condor.
No, sir. The president.
Alice here.
This is the president speaking.
Hold on. Hold on. Dayward.
I don't think we have time for that, General.
Give me that Dayward or you're talking to yourself.
Dayward, Cottonmouth. Command word, Trinity. Action word, Jericho. Now you probably ask me for the authenticator codes, right?
Keep going, you're on a roll.
I don't have my authenticator cards, Alice. Besides, I'm blind and I couldn't read the damn things if I did.
Without that card, I don't know who you are.
So what do we do now? You want to quiz me on the Brooklyn Dodgers, Betty Grable's measurements?
I'm disconnecting.
Now hold it, General. This is the President of the United States. Now we could play this by the book if you'd like and blow the damn world to smithereens. Now is that what you want? Now look, I need a pass through to the E4. The Secretary of Interior thinks he's a president. I need to talk to him fast. It's about the submarines. Do you understand?
Without those codes, the E4 won't give you the time of day.
You can give me the goddamn codes. No, I need a patch through to the E4. Will you do it?
I'm sorry, sir.
For God's sakes, it's me, Charlie. Look, we gotta stop this damn thing now. It's down to us.
Recall the bombers, Sam.
What?
You heard me. We have a new commander-in-chief.
Hey. Hey, look down there. Well, these boys look serious.
I'd say real serious.
Polar Bear 1, this is Red Fox 1 of USS Midway Pacific Battle Group on guard.
Jesus, famous.
That's us, pal.
We have NCA orders to escort you to a water landing and rescue or shoot you down. Polar Bear 1, do you understand?
Sorry, friend. My partner is afraid of sharks.
Polar Bear 1, do you know what a sidewinder will do to your crate?
A little short on humor.
Hey, sailor. You want to say goodbye to the lady on my rank here first?
We don't want to do this, buddy.
Affirmative, Agent. A course change. All
right, we got it. The President is on the line, sir.
Sir, I've turned the bombers, but I cannot issue orders to the submarines. The Air Force cannot give orders to the Navy.
Mr. President, the Navy has 2 TACAMO planes for communicating to the subs, one over the Atlantic, the other over the Pacific.
They'll take orders only from the President or his successor. Sir? I must give you the authenticator codes.
Condor.
My God, is that what they call you? I wouldn't stand for that if I were you, Mr. Secretary.
Mr. President?
I'm afraid the reports of my death have been greatly exaggerated. I'm told you've done a superb job in my absence, and I congratulate you. Now we must work together to take the next step. The bombers have already been turned, but we haven't much time.
You turned the bombers?
We must stop the submarines. It's going to take the two of us. We must give orders for a ceasefire. Then we'll put what's left of our country back on its feet.
The Russians have people trained to sound like the president.
Who is this?
Do you want me to give you the authenticator codes?
I certainly do.
See, even if he gets the numbers right, see, they could have intercepted our communications by now. The Russians may have the code.
Who the hell is this?
This is the president. Johnny.
The real president would do what's right for the country.
Shut up. Just shut up.
Two weeks ago, in a speech I heard the president say, this is not the time to let down our guard when it comes to the Soviet Union. Radical change brings chaos. Turn back our bombers? Stop our subs? No. Never. I must be talking to somebody else.
You know damn well who this is. You're making a monumental mistake.
Red Fox 1, this is Midway CIC. You were cleared to engage and destroy Polar Bear 1.
Roger that.
You gonna eject?
I don't know. It's your job, they'll pull you out.
Lost you in the sun, Red Fox 1.
About 2 o'clock, you'll pick me up in a second.
Gotta listen to the play-by-play.
Roger, got you.
You want a black hood?
All right, let's not get a bloody nose. Okay, Red Fox 1, pull in tighter. See him? Roger 2, got him 3 miles. Okay, 1, let's go for it. Tom?
2.
Real shit duty, isn't it?
Everything's shit duty today. In we go, Red Fox 2.
Oh, this guy's got a lot of heart.
Everybody's doing their duty today.
Mayday, mayday. This is Midway CIC. Midway has been hit.
Holy hell, the carrier's been torpedoed.
Harpoon reporting, sir.
Yes, sir. A question. Who is authorized to issue new orders to the submarines?
Only you can issue orders to the subs using the Tacomal planes.
And if someone counterfeited the codes so that the orders appeared to come from me?
I don't see how they could.
What happens if the Tacomal planes receive conflicting orders?
What's going on, sir? Did Dallas turn the B-52s?
I asked you a question, sir.
He did. He turned them. What did the Russian bombers do? The Russian bombers turned in response, didn't they? You can't even consider using the subs
now. Talk to me about conflicting orders.
The Soviets couldn't send us a clearer signal.
What they've given us, Admiral, is a clear military advantage. Our subs against the remaining ICBMs, no contest.
What happens if the Tacomo planes get conflicting orders? Your president asked you a question, sir.
Both sets of orders have the proper codes. The planes will follow the original orders. The subs will fire at 1400 Zulu.
That's all. You're dismissed.
This isn't about Russia anymore. It's God's work you're destroying now.
You're dismissed, sir.
Freeze, freeze! Oh, shoot! Shoot! Bring down the plane! Go ahead, please, shoot!
How far from the E-4 are you?
120 miles, sir.
There must be some other way.
I'm afraid not, sir. If you can contact Tacomo planes, you can bet E-4 can. If the subs get conflicting orders, they will fire as planned in 1 hour.
I don't know what to say, General, except thank you.
No thanks necessary, Mr. President.
Alice, will you call again before?
Before we ram them. Sure.
Thank you.
Is a girl smoke, Sam?
My wife says they won't kill me as fast.
Red Fox One, you're not gonna bring us down?
What's the point? Our carrier's gone. We got no place to land. Not gonna drag you down with us.
What's the tag along? Palm trees, coconuts, native girls?
That's a negative, thanks. We blew half our gas getting up here. We'd be running on vapors long before we got to paradise.
Ain't that always the truth?
Say, polar bear.
Yeah, Red Fox.
Later, when we come paddling in, you bring on those dancing girls here.
You bet, Red Fox.
Luck.
Turn that thing off.
You don't care about the radiation anymore, sir?
No, I don't.
What should we care about now?
Smitty? Care about catching E4.
Colonel, I show an aircraft less than 100 miles in closing.
You got an ID?
I believe it's the looking glass, sir.
What the hell are they doing there?
Yes, Fargo. Evade him.
We got him on radar, sir. Looks like we're both flying the same speed, but they're dodging the hot clouds. If we fly straight through, we should catch up pretty quick.
Gentlemen, we must now regard the looking glass plane as an enemy aircraft manned by treasonous men. Flanders, we'll look to you to keep him off us. No more flying around radioactive clouds, understood?
Yes, sir.
That'll be all, gentlemen. Thank you. Dismissed. You keep your eye on the pilot.
Are you all right, sir?
Yeah, I'm fine, John. Thanks.
Can the Russians be jamming us?
No, but they can listen over their tube on the satellites, sir.
Where are they?
Right now, they've got one over the Atlantic and one over the Pacific, sir.
Okay, we're in business. Give me a hookup.
It'll be difficult, but I'll try, sir.
Sorry, sir, I'm getting nothing from the Tacoma planes.
Try the low frequency channels.
There they are.
Where? Yeah, I see them.
Looks like they're going back on a straight course. They're gonna take the rats, too. This is gonna make it tougher.
You're doing good, Smitty.
Am I improving the odds?
About 90 to 1.
Ladder number 6!
Shut it down!
Good.
Runner!
Got it!
Altitude?
Are you kidding? Prepare to get us some bombs.
I've got them, sir.
Good work, Lieutenant.
Alice, we made our way through to the Tacoma planes. Unfortunately, the E-4 beat us to it.
Conflicting orders, Mr. President. The submarines will launch.
The Tacomos have asked for confirmation. It'll take a few minutes to move the codes. Can you catch them in 5 minutes?
Sorry, sir. They're going straight through, too. We can't gain on them.
Try.
Of course, sir. We'll try.
What the hell time is it?
1355 hours, sir.
Call us back in exactly 2 minutes. 1357 hours exactly. We're counting seconds now, Alice. The fate of this planet may be riding with you.
Yes, sir. Smitty. Burn out every fan in those engines. You've got 5 minutes or it's all over.
That may not do any good, sir, but I'll try.
Will somebody give me a cigarette? A real cigarette!
Going full thrust, all engines.
Roger that, we are still descending.
Damn it, we're not gonna make it. Too rough to dash, prepare to eject.
Wait! We are holding altitude. We are holding altitude. I think we got a chance.
Roger that. Looks like the storm's breaking up.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes?
We've just reached the Tacoma Plains. You've got to bring down your authenticator card.
Oh, in heaven's name did you do that?
We went through two Russian satellites to reach our planes. How's that for sticking it to them?
Good work. Well, let's get on to it.
Excuse me, sir. Where the hell is Alice?
Right on our tail, sir.
Keep that bastard off us for 15 minutes if you want to win this war.
Win? I thought we were supposed to stop this thing.
Sir?
Yeah?
Non-filter, sir.
God bless you, Mary.
General, it's the President, sir.
General, I have the Kremlin on the line. His people are monitoring the E4 transmission. You have 3, maybe 4 minutes. Can you do it in that time?
No, sir, I cannot.
You understand what this means?
Yes, sir.
It's hopeless?
Well, sir, the E4 pilot makes a mistake. Slips up, maybe, but he won't. I know him. He's good. Right now, he sees himself pursued by a madman.
General.
Sir.
Against your wishes, I'm going to thank you. Not all our people's programming was faulty.
Because we're using an unconventional relay, sir, it can take 5 or 6 minutes. They don't want voice, they want it on paper in a specific sequence, or it'll be ignored.
Well, then, let's get on with it, huh? Right away.
Thank you, sir.
President, I think we got him. Sir, do better next time, sir.
Taking the chance to live. It's okay to die.
Nobody's dying now.
Where do we go from here?
I don't know. Welcome to tomorrow.